What I have, so in about 10 minutes, we will talk about the spoken tutorial. Apparently, you had some questions. How many people had spoken tutorials, questions? Some people wanted to even set up. In fact, our objective is that every one of you will have as infrastructure set up to do spoken tutorials. So what I have done is, what we will do is, let us play that video fully. Okay, how to do the recording through CamStudio. Okay, and if there are questions, we have Nancy here. Can you raise your hand? Yeah, who actually created that. So let me play this first, because some of you had questions on.
Audio video demonstrations can illustrate features with maximum clarity. CamStudio is a screen recording software that records all activities which you see on your computer screen and allows you to play them back later on, which means that you can use CamStudio to demonstrate features of a new software, create audio video tutorials for schools and colleges, create video movies used in user training, show how to perform an activity, convert AVI files to flash files, and many other uses. The uses of this little known software are limitless. CamStudio can be used with Microsoft Windows 95, 98, ME, NT4, 2000, or XP versions. All you need is a 400 MHz processor, 64 MB of RAM, and 4 MB of hard disk space for program installation. CamStudio is an open source software and can be downloaded free of cost from the internet. Go to the site www.camstudio.org. This will open the CamStudio website. Scroll down and click on the link to download. Follow the instructions and you will have downloaded CamStudio on your PC. Once you have installed CamStudio, double click on the icon to run it. This will open the CamStudio dialog box. You will see the main menu right at the top of the window. Under File, you have the options to record, stop, pause, and exit. You will find the corresponding buttons in the dialog box as well. The red button to record, the gray button to pause, and the blue button to stop the recording. It is recommended that you set the capture region before recording by defining the area of capture. Under Region, there are three capture options. If you select Region and click on Record, then you can draw a rectangular region on your screen within which the capturing will occur. If you select Fixed Region, then you can specify the capture region in pixels. If you select Full Screen, then the entire screen will be captured. The Enable Auto Pan feature is a unique feature of CamStudio. If this option is selected, the capture region will follow the cursor wherever it goes during recording. This has the effect of making the screen capture to occur at the region with the most action. You can also set the speed of panning here. Under Options, you have Video options, where you can select a compressor for the recording so that the video file size is small. By default, the compressor is Microsoft Video 1. But you are free to choose any of the compressors or codecs given in the drop-down box here. Alternately, you can even download the codecs from the internet depending on your requirement. Setting the video options allows you to optimize your video recordings by choosing between the file size, quality, and frame rates of your video files. To set the values for keyframes, capture frames, and the playback rate, first uncheck the auto adjust button. Now you can set the values according to your requirement. To record this tutorial, I have used Microsoft Video 1 as the compressor, with keyframes set to 5, capture frames set to 200, and playback rate set to 5. I have reduced the quality to 50. By trial and error and various permutations and combinations, I have personally found these values suitable in terms of output quality and file size. Setting cursor options can help focus on the activity you are recording by drawing attention to the area where the action happens. under options, click on cursor options, in which you have the choice to either hide or show the cursor. By default, show cursor is checked. There are three choices of cursors here: the actual cursor, the custom cursor, you can select from the drop-down box here, or you can load the cursor from the cursors folder present on your computer. Next, you can highlight the area around the cursor by checking this box. You can set the size, the shape, and the color of the highlight. Click on OK. You will not see any change in your cursor, but the recorded video will have a custom highlighted cursor. Let me demonstrate this for you. By default, CamStudio does not record audio. You can record audio from the microphone, a very powerful feature to make audio-video tutorials, by checking this option. You will need a sound card with an attached microphone to use this option. You can also record audio from the speakers attached to your computer by checking this option. There are other options like program options, which have these sub-options. Use these options to customize the way CamStudio behaves when it starts or stops recording. Ideally, check the option to minimize program on start recording. This will minimize CamStudio onto the system tray, which is at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. Right now, you will see two CamStudio icons on the system tray. That's because I myself am recording this tutorial using CamStudio. Record to flash options has these sub-options. Keyboard shortcuts is where you will set the hotkeys for record, pause, stop, and the rest. You're free to choose any of these. So I hope I have given you sufficient information to get you started on CamStudio. Use this software to make audio-video tutorials and online visual learning modules of your own. Once you have mastered the basics of CamStudio, you may want to watch the next edition on its advanced features. Till then, this is Nancy from CDEEP IIT Bombay signing off. Thank you for watching.
Any Linux-based recording software available? If you want, I want to explain some Linux program or anything, I can use it.
Yeah, XvidCap is one that is available on Linux. XvidVID. V-I-D. X video capture, so X, VID, CAP. I played that Scilab thing the other day by a Gujarat student. She had used XvidCap. Okay, this I think I showed some LaTeX also. That was done using IShowU, which is a shareware in Mac OS X, which means I paid $20. Okay, actually you should talk to Nancy about what is involved in making it. I mean, one is technology that you have seen, but what is, you want to say a few things? What is the most difficult part in this, or what are, name a few important things in this?
If you can just take one slide and just add audio to it and demonstrate how exactly we do it. One PowerPoint slide.
Okay, so you saw that LaTeX thing. So what I did was, I have, of course, you know, this is a different software. I took it to the top left hand corner, and of course I know the size, it should be 79 by 10. Okay, that is the size of the window that I have. Then I say CD desktop. Okay, so I have this file, which of course I made it smaller. You need some initial work to do. You have to arrange things. So I arrange them like this. Okay. All right, suppose I just want to start like now. okay, let's say I want to compile this LaTeX. So I have something called, so I have the hotkey for this, okay. Okay, now whatever I'm going to say is getting recorded. Of course, in this, you see this red line that is coming up. So what I will do is, I will, using the hotkey, I will terminate it. Okay, so this is that MOV file that has captured the whole screen. Whatever that came within this stuff has come, right? See this? So if I play this.
Okay, now whatever I'm going to say is getting recorded. Of course, in this, you see this red line that is coming up. So what I will do is, I will, using the hotkey, I will terminate it.
So very simple. Let us show the CamStudio.
I'll just do a small demo recording. As we had explained in the earlier tutorial that you all saw, there are three capture regions in which you can do the recording. If you do this, then you can draw your region, the capture region. Now, the moment I leave the mouse, everything, you will notice that there are four corners here. This shows the region within which the capturing is going to occur. If I want to record, say, a PowerPoint presentation, I will just open one which is here on this laptop. This is just for demonstration purpose. So, go back to CamStudio and choose full screen and click on record. Ideally, as I said before, please choose this option, minimize the program on start recording. This will make sure that the CamStudio window disappears the moment the recording starts. Yeah, so the moment I press record, this window will disappear. Now, whatever is there in the PPT will be captured. I'll just save this on the desktop.
So, you have terminated recording?
I have stopped the recording. I'll save the file. This is the default CamStudio player in which you can view whatever you have recorded just now. So I'll just play this.
So I think she forgot to turn the audio on.
Yes.
I think the default is audio off.
Yes.
So you have to remember to. You want to say how long you took to create that? How to do CamStudio recording?
How to do CamStudio took about a month to make. The reason being that CamStudio was a new software to me. So I had to first understand how it works. And every little detail that goes into it, because there's no point in telling others to do something which actually doesn't work. So what I would recommend for any spoken tutorial is to study the topic that you want to show in the tutorial very well, make a very good script, do some recordings, go through your recordings, find out if there is any ambiguity, if there is any loose ends, you know, somewhere where the meaning is not being conveyed properly, or if there is too much of information given on something or too less information given on some other detail. All that has, you know, you have to go through it. It is not, you can't just do it like in 1 or 2 days. No, you have to take the time
to do a thorough job. Kannan sir always is a very tough taskmaster, so he makes me do it till I get it right. But that is good. It is good because you can get a concise and precise tutorial to the point. Sometimes we need not say things, you know, which are not required at all. You know, the student will understand.
Let me just add a word of, it is not actually so difficult. I asked Nancy to spend a lot of effort in that tutorial, namely CamStudio, because we wanted people to use that. We wanted a lot of people to use that. So I wanted it to be as good as possible. We were also going to get it dubbed into many languages. So in view of that, we wanted it to be really nice. But on the other hand, if somebody is going to create one of how to do browsing, you know, you may not even dub it. It's available. Anybody can go and listen to it. So that is okay. So anybody who is comfortable with any software, they want to talk about it, they need some practice. But not months of, she actually said 1 month, actually she took 2 months. Okay? The thing is about what to put, what not to put, and what compression and so on. So for example, in one of the places she says, I chose 5 frames, I did this, I choose the quality at 50%. By trial and error, I arrived at it. How much time did she spend to arrive at that? Days, yes. If not weeks.
Days.
Okay? But once it is given, a person who is picking it up, you set it up, it's going to come out good.
Yes.
Right? So I believe that it is possible without too much effort to replicate this. Now that the spoken tutorial on how to create it is available, right? It is very easy for you to do that. I don't think it will take days, I mean months.
No.
Nowadays, there are times when I create, it's a real time. You have everything right, you speak, finish it, it's over. Recording is done. Of course, she has spent some time on editing. My spoken tutorials on LaTeX, I don't do editing. It's one go. 15 minutes, just go through with this, finished, released. Not even editing. If you do editing, cut, paste, and so on, it'll take time.
Yes.